Hello everyone, this is me, Satya here, and I'm doing your first week of June reading start from the 1st through the 7th of June 2021. This reading is going to be for the sign of Sagittarius, so let's see how the first week of June is going to be for the sign of Sagittarius. I will be adding oracle cards in this reading, but no charms will be added, so stay tuned. And while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you, it's a general reading, it may not resonate with everyone out there, so always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal reads, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily readings. So, Sagittarians, let's see what is coming up for you guys for this week time, which has already started. Sagittarius, first week of June, let's begin. Knight of Pentacles, paired up with Three of Wands, paired up with Page of Wands. Seven of Pentacles, the Magician, the Hangman. Wow, there must be some planetary movements which is causing delays in everybody's life here this week time. So it seems like you might be feeling, you might feel the need to pursue something in your life, but then there are certain delays. You want things to work out well for you. You want things to work out quick for you, but then there are delays, and that's going to be like, you know, make you feel like, you know, if I'm doing things right, if I'm doing things, you know, it seems like, you know, whatever the delays are, just know one thing for sure, that these delays are not gonna be a block in your life. I mean, I just did one more reading, and it seems like, you know, this is something planetary that is going on, which is causing delays in everybody's life. Now, don't let the delay get the best of you or the situation. Let this delay be as a blessing in disguise. The only way to deal with the delays, the better way, is you taking it as a blessing in disguise. Now, for instance, if you are running late for your interview, job, whatever it is, make sure that you don't think negative. Don't take it as a block. Maybe you're gonna miss out the interview. Maybe you're gonna find a better job, better interview the next you know, day. So take it as a blessing in disguise. Don't take it as a stress or, you know, a stressful thing to deal with. Something good is going to come out of it. Now, for some of you, I feel like, you know, there are certain things that you want to work out well for you right now, but then because of the delays, you would feel like, you know, maybe you need to take on to, you know, other opportunities. Now, it's very important, if you could be patient with the situation that you are dealing with, things will get better for you. Better opportunities, better life decisions could be made if you wait for things to happen. Don't rush into things, because I feel like, you know, the delays are gonna make you take wrong decisions. If that's happening in your life, if you're facing some delays in your life, just relax around it. You don't have to rush into things. You just have to relax, because the more you relax, the more are the chances that you're gonna becoming magnet to all that you desire. The more you're going to take you know, aggressive action decisions because you are facing some delays in your plans, it's just going to attract you wrong things, wrong opportunities, which you will later on regret. You would wish I had not chosen that thing to, you know, to pursue. Now, it's very important, be that in love, work, home life situation, if you have to wait for the perfect time, wait for the perfect one. If you are single and if you are meeting a specific someone and you feel like, you know, maybe this is not how I wanted my person to be, I don't know if I will ever find the one that I wanted, then again, don't rush into it. Don't rush into any relationship just because you have to be in one. Wait on for the kind of person that you have asked for, because that person will come in. If you rush into things, you will regret the decision and you would feel like, you know, you need to put an end to that. So again, be patient. Whatever that you want will come to you. Just for now, you have to believe in the process, believe in the delays. These delays are definitely not blocks. So don't take them as block, because that's you blocking your own path towards what you have asked for. Believe that something beautiful is coming. Believe that what you have asked for is coming. So don't rush into making any decision. I feel like, you know, for majority of you in this week time, you have to stay very positive around what you have asked for and what you believe in. Because I do see that maybe situation is not going to pan out the way you want or the way you desire, But yes, if you become patient around whatever area it applies to, you will get even better than what you have asked for. So just know something magically is gonna come through for you. Be that in love, work, home life situation, some better opportunities, some better outcomes are definitely coming in. Maybe not the sweet time. You have to stay patient around it. The more you stay patient, the more you are having chance of getting more than what you have asked for. So just try to stay patient. Something beautiful is gonna come through for you the next week. Yes, this week you have to kind of just try to let things be. Things will be slow, things will be delayed, which is perfectly fine. Don't let that kind of get on your nerves, because it's just gonna create an unnecessary situation where you will have to. It's just gonna make you regret your decision if you take any decision during this week time. So just slow down, just slow down. The universe doesn't want you to rush into anything, and if you rush into things, you're gonna regret that. So don't rush into things. Let's see what the oracle has to add to the read for you guys, Sagittarians. Let's see what you are being guided by the universe. Let's take these two cards. You and your loved ones are safe. If you are on the waiting side for a specific someone and you really love this person and you have other opportunities, other offers coming in, maybe you need to wait on for the one that you love because you and your loved ones are safe. So if you think that maybe you're gonna miss out the opportunity of falling, of having the person in your love life, you cannot wait for the specific someone any longer. Maybe you can because that person will come in. Maybe not this week time, but yes, you have a strong possibility of them coming back to you. So again, try to be patient around it. Have faith in your dreams. Again, try to believe in what you have asked for and you will get that. It's very important for you to not to rush into things in this week time. It's not gonna be ideal situation to deal with, or this will not be the ideal way to deal with the current situation. So just have patience. You deserve the best. Reach for the stars with your dreams and desires and don't compromise. It's high time that you understand that whatever you have asked for, you will get that. So you don't have to compromise. You don't have to settle in for less. Wait for whatever you have asked for. Trust me, you will get that. Let's take one card from this deck and then we're gonna take one more card and then we are done for this week. Wow. Just wait for something beautiful to come in. Don't rush into things. Seven of Emotion. Your angels are asking you to make an important decision that you have been putting off. It's likely you know which choice you should make, but you are procrastinating so you don't upset someone else. Ask heaven for guidance and then make the choice and celebrate who you truly are. Now, for some of you might be thinking to take a decision based on other person's, happiness. Again, don't do that. Whatever makes you happy, whatever satisfies your soul, whatever makes you feel like, yes, this is the decision that I wanted to make, go with that. Because otherwise, you're gonna regret it again. Now, maybe for some of you, you really want to say no to a specific someone, say no to a job. But then you would feel like maybe I should accept it. Now, again, it's very important for you to listen to your inner calling around it. Don't rush into any decision making during this time. Even if you have been ignoring to make that decision, like this card suggests, maybe you have been kind of, overthinking around it. But yes, the inner knowing has been telling you that take this decision, make this decision, listen to it, and you will be guided through the right path forward. Be that in love, work, or home life situation. Let's take more cards. Healing. Imagine yourself and your beloved surrounded by light. Feel your relationship being healed this very moment. It's going to be a very important time where you could heal yourself and the person and the connection that you have with the specific someone. If you have been waiting on for a specific someone to come back, maybe it's very important time for you to use this delayed period of time to heal the connection that you had with them. Don't think of what didn't work well for you. Just feel as if the connection has been healed by the heavens and you are coming back together. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this week time. If the reading resonated with you, do like, share, and subscribe. And if you're willing to get a personal reading or any of the services that I offer, you can check the description box for further details on that. If you really want to manifest a specific someone back in your life, again, you can check the description box for further details on that. You can use scripting affirmations to make it happen for you. And now, while you wait, it's very important for you to stay positive and listen to the inner calling. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this week time. If the reading resonated, do like, share, and subscribe. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care. Bye-bye.